Morning, everybody. Welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going how you migrate from analysis services over to Power BI Premium per user or Premium Gen 2. Super excited about this topic. I've been working on both of these for, well, 6 months or longer even right now, and I'm really excited to be out from underneath the NDAs and that I can talk to you and show you about how incredible this is. Okay, so we're going to be going over how you move from analysis services or even SSAS, either one, into Power BI Premium. Okay, now this could be the per user. You're going to see per user in here, but it's the exact same experience for Gen 2. Gen 2 is a little faster. Let's over to my desktop and let's check it out. Okay, so these are the models that we deployed out into our data sets. We've got SSAS out. We've got a data set and a report. And then we have AAS, and we've got a data set and a report. Kind of pain in the neck. What we're going to do is we're going to replace these with a connection over to Power BI Premium. So the big thing you need to have first is you need to make sure that you have your premium content on, and it needs to be either premium per user or premium. Inside your settings, this is going to be a big thing that you're going to need to make sure that you do. Under your premium per user, you need to make sure that you have read, write, XMLA endpoints turned on. And as you can see, I do here. You're going to have to make sure that you work with your tenant admins to make sure that it's turned on inside each your premium capacities. That is an optional feature, so some premium capacities will have this enabled, some won't. Once this is set up, you're all ready to begin your migration over from analysis services over. So I'm going to fire up my tabular editor. Now, here is a little secret I'm going to give you. Make sure you go and you grab your RW or your read-write analysis services or your RW on SSAS. I don't know why it works like this, but it does. But if you go over here, click on this. Now, this is my RW service that I'm going to connect to. Okay, and I connect to it. All right, once I've connected to this, it becomes really easy to make this deployment. Now, here's the secret. I'm going to go into my Power BI workspace that I've already configured for Power BI Premium. All right, I'm going to go under Settings, and I'm going to go to my Premium tab right here, and I'm going to click on Copy. Once I have the URL copied, I'm going to go over back over to Tabular Editor. I'm going to go to Model and choose Deploy. I'm going to paste in my new URL. I'm going to click on Next. It's going to, again, authenticate. Going to be good to go. And I'm going to call this one my Kratos BI data underscore PBI Prem. And next, deploy. All right. This is going to run. You can also generate some scripts, the scripts as part of this, and you can execute those against directly against the Power BI instance if you want to. If you do, you're going to notice some kind of new little error messages. They just kind of like flash up, and then they run successfully. You can go ahead and take a look at them. I've talked with Microsoft about them. They don't really have any meaning or anything, so it's all good to go. So if I head back over to my Power BI workspace, I now have something out here, which is the Power BI data set that's out inside of the instance with no report attached to this. So I can go through and I can delete all of these other guys if I wanted to, and I can just be running on this guy in a go-forward basis. Because I want to, big key, make sure that you have set your gateway up on here. So make sure you go into your gateway connection. It's going to take a little while to refresh. Bah, 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 bah. All right, I'm going to choose my Kratos BI Enterprise Gateway. I'm going to choose my server. I'm going to click on Apply. I'm going to be all set to go. I go back to the workspace. I hit on refresh now. It's going to run, and I'm going to see that my data set is now live inside of the Power BI service. This is an incredible step forward because now I no longer have to manage SSAS. I no longer have to manage analysis services. I no longer have to manage any of that stuff. I can do all of my work in the Power BI service at all. That simplifies my architecture, that keeps my costs under, down and under control, especially with Power BI Gen 2. You're going to see some massive advantages for enterprises when it comes to managing these models. All right. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. I absolutely love these new opportunities that we have to share this with you guys. Please, if you have questions, post them in the chat below. Or if you like this video, let me know. Put it down there. You want to see something else, leave it in the chat. Make sure you hit like. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and share this with all your friends. Thank you guys again for everything. Have a great day. Peace.